Yes. Once again, welcome the all of you the lecture series of microprocessors and microcontrollers. Now today we are going to discuss the one of the controller. You can call it as a DMA controller. DMA controller 8257. So DMA means here direct memory access. You know that the name itself it gives some answer. Direct memory access. DMA here nothing but the direct memory access. See this. We are placing this interfacing devices here. Interfacing devices. So our one of the devices DMA 8257. Direct memory access. So nothing but without interference of the nothing but much interference of the CPU. You are transferring memory to the one device to the another device. That is the DMA control without interference of the CPU. Okay, you are transferring memory from one device to the another device. Okay, so in normally how the data is moved from one device to the another device. So one device is requesting a data to the CPU. Okay. So CPU is send the information to the interfacing device to the memory. This is nothing but this is the way. So one device to this device to this device. This is the information passing. At the same time, all the interface is transferred to memory to the some interfacing device to the CPU. This is the way. But you are reducing the CPU burden. So we are directly transfer the memory from one device to the another device, from input to the memory through the DMA, not the CPU. In the normal case, whenever an input device is want the data from the memory, so you send the request to the for interfacing device to the CPU, and again CPU to this interfacing device to the memory, memory to the. So this process is goes on. This two-way process. But this device by using this DMA controller, so you reduces the burden of the CPU nothing but without CPU interference, you are transferring data from one device to the another device, nothing but the input to the DMA to the memory, or memory to the DMA to the input output devices. So memory to the DMA to the input output device, or input output device to the 8257 or 8257 to the memory. So we are reducing the interference of the CPU. So this is one of the fastest data transfer method. This is one of the fastest data transfer. So you can directly, data is directly transferred to or from nothing but you can transfer the information, you can at the same time receive the information from the memory without any interference of the CPU. That is the primary motive of the detection of the DMA. So direct memory access. This is also developed by the Intel. This is also developed by the Intel. So the only way we are using the CPU is you have to tell that CPU. So we are transferring the information from one device to the another device. You are just passing the information to the CPU. You just pass the information to the CPU. You are transferring information from the one device to the another. So the only way we are interacting the CPU is that one, that is hold acknowledgement signals. Hold acknowledgement signal in minimum mode, as well as request RT and GT, request and RQ or GQ, request and request grant signals in the manual. In one mode we are using hold and hold acknowledgement signal. In another mode, you know that the CPU is working two modes, minimum mode as well as the maximum. So in one mode we are using hold and hold acknowledgement signal. In another mode we are using request and request grant signals. So these are only used to give the information to the CPU. We are transferring the memory from one device to the another device. Anything but one memory device to the another memory device, or some input output device to the memory device. Okay, so how it is possible? Memory transfer is very easy. So how is possible? This is a CPU. is a CPU. So we are just only giving the information to that CPU only in the name of hold or request. So if it is accepted, it generates the microprocessor, generates the signal. A hold acknowledgement or grant signal. So this is 8-2 DMA 8257. In this device, we are going to whatever that device we are going to connect. They may be of input output device. We are connected here and 4 input output device. Device 1, 2, 3. We are going to connect 4 input output devices by using this 8257. So this is DMA, some input output devices. Whenever this input output devices is want the memory, I will draw the memory here. So this input output, devices is given request to that DMA controller. DMA controller is send the information to the CPU. So see this, how that process is happen. You can draw this. So input output device is request to the DMA controller. So for the memory accessing, this DMA controller is send information to the CPU. I'm transferring the data from memory to the input output devices. So CPUs accept that request, is send the hold acknowledgement signal. That CPU functionality is over. Then after that, this DMA controller will send the read and write cycles to that memory. So then getting the information from the memory. Then after transfer the information directly to the 8257 to the input output devices. So this information nowhere go to the CPU. This memory data. In normal cases, so any input output device is requesting the memory. So request is accepted by the CPU. Then CPU is generated the read and write cycles. Then that information is going back to the CPU, then CPU to the input output device. A two-way process, a lengthy process is happening normally. So by using this one, so we are reduces the usage of the CPU. So directly you can transfer the information from the input output device to the DMA, DMA to the memory, memory to the DMA, DMA to the input output device. Okay, this is very easy. So here remember, a DMA is generates the read and nothing but RD bar and WR bar signals, read and write cycles. So you just send the information from input output device to the memory and memory to the input output device. So sending information means here write operation, send means a write operation, read means here copy. Okay. Then what are some features of the this DMA controller? It has 16 bit addresses each of and a 14 bit counter, nothing but the 16 bit addresses. You know that in memory, you know that memory is 16 bit. You know that memory is a 16 bit addresses. Memory. Total it is a 20 bit. Out of 20 bit, segment address plus offset address we are giving. So here we are using 16 bit addresses lines to identify the memory locations. So each channel can transfer up to the memory of 64 KB. You know that 2 power 16 is equal to the 64 KB. So it can hold the data up to the 64 KB. So each channel can be programmed independently. You have the 4 channels, remember? 4 channels. You have the 4 channels are available. So for 4 channels, we are going to connect the 4 different types of input output devices. 4 different types of the input output devices. Okay, so we can programming the each channel separately. So each channel can perform read and write operations and verify the transfer operations. So it requires the single phase clock. Why? Because this DMA controller is only perform the read and write operations. If it can perform the read and write operations, it requires this clock cycles. So for performing this read and write operations, it requires the 4 clock cycles. 4 clock cycles. So what is the frequency range of this one? 250 hertz to the 3 mega hertz of that clock. So it operates in two modes, master and slave mode. It operates in two modes, master and slave. See this. This is the basic architecture of the DMA controller. Now this is, you can see this. This is the channel zero. This is the four channels. One or two or three or four. Four channels. Are nothing but channel zero, channel one, channel two, channel three, whatever. Channel zero, another microprocessor starts at any number from the zero. Channel zero, channel one, channel two, channel three, four channels. Out of this four channel, we are going to get, this is one of the input output device. 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 So a four input output device we are going to connect. Four input output devices. We are going to connect this using the DMA controller. So this is very much similar to the our programmable interrupt controller. Programmable interrupt controller. Likewise, programmable interrupt controller. You know that in programmable interrupt controller, you have 8 requests, interrupt request. So for suppose what are the interrupt request? IR0 to the IR7. So IR0 has the highest priority, IR7 has the lowest. Similarly, whenever you are connecting the any device to the channel 0, the channel 0 has the highest priority device when compared to the channel. The priority is reduces when goes down to the channel. So whenever you are connecting any device to the channel 0, or whenever you are selecting you wish to connect any device to the channel zero, that is the highest priority device, remember. So then after the channel one, then after the channel two, then after the channel three. So see this, you know that this is the CPU side. 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 Right. See this. This is the CPU set 8086. You know that for every interface device, it has the data bus buffer, then read and write control logic. Then this is the some extra lines we are going to utilize here. So A4 lines, A5, A6, A7 lines, and ready. So HRQ, hold acknowledgement and hold signals, memory read, memory write signals. So these are the some signals we are using. So this is the CPU side. So this is the device. This is the out. This is the this side is going to connect the any of the input output device. This is our 8257. This is our 8257 device. So it's very. So this is also the priority resolver. So this, when you are programming to the priority resolver, so you want to change the priorities of this four channels. You are writing the programming to this priority resolver. So without writing that one, so channel zero has the highest priority when compared to the channel one, then compared to the channel two, then compared to the channel. So this is the some basic structure of this. So you know that you see this, it has the 16-bit address and as well as the control registers. So each channel has the two registers. Remember, each channel has the two registers. One is the control, one is the address register, DMA address register, and the one is the control register. So each channel, so nothing but 4 into 2 is nothing but 8 registers are there. Okay, so plus another two registers are also available. One is the mode set register, and another one is the status. Totally you have 10 registers are there in the DMA controller. 10 registers are there. So out of the 10 registers, so DMA address register and the terminal count register are control registers. So these are available 4 channels into the 2. Each channel has 8 registers. 8 registers. Then one mode set register. more centrist, nothing but this will decide. It is very much similar to the CWR. So whenever you are writing the programming, CPU, whenever you are writing the programming to, that means writing the program to the CPU. CPU send information to the 8257. So nothing but it can read and write the mode set of the registers. Then after the one status register. One status register. Totally 10 registers are available. 10 registers. 8 are in the channels. 8 are in the channels. Nothing but 2 is nothing but one is the DMA address. One is the address. DMA address. And another one is the count register. Terminal count register. Totally 10 registers. What is this DMA address register? What is this DMA address register? You know that why it is required this register? What is the purpose of this register? So what is the use of this register? You know that you can call it as an address register. Remember, this is a 16-bit address register. It is a 16-bit address register. 16-bit address register. 16-bit address register. What is the use of this 16-bit address register? You know that this 8257 only generates the, this only generates the read cycles as well as the write cycles. So whenever it can perform the read and write operations to that memory locations, you require the addresses. Require the addresses, then only MicroBoss is going, nothing but this 8257 is going to that memory address locations. It may be perform read operation or write operation. Nothing but maybe copy the information, or it may be overwrite, nothing but send the information. So that purpose, you must require the address addresses register. This address location has the starting address of that memory location. This address location has the function of this register is to store the address of the starting address of the memory location. See, the starting address of the memory location, which will be accessed by the DMA channel. It can store the starting address of the, so likewise segment address or physical address is nothing but segment address plus offset address. So this is also 16-bit, this is also 16-bit. Where you are moving 4-bit positions ahead, it forms the 20-bit addresses. So this offset, this segment address means it can produces the starting address of that segments. Likewise, this DMA address registers will store the starting address of the memory location. So which starting address it stores the MicroBoss nothing but DMA channel, which memory segment is going to accessing, that starting address is stores this information. Okay, then what is the terminal counter register? So this will tells that each of this terminal count means so each of this DMA channel has one terminal count register, you know that. So this 16-bit register is used for ascertaining that the data transferred through the DMA channel ceases or stops after the request number of DMA cycles. So it can count or it can terminate the operations performed by the DMA. Once that operation is over, you not still my DMA control is still not continuing that operation. So that the terminating purpose, we are going to use this terminal count. So what is that? These are these two types are available. These are the available in 4. So this DMA addresses also 4, but each channel series. Each channel series. Each, this is channel 0, channel 1, channel 2, channel 3. Each channel has the one DMA address register, DMA address register, and then one terminal count register PC. Each channel. So 8 registers are there. So the next one is the one mode set register. Mode set register is only one mode set register. So this program is, this is very much similar to the CWR. So come a command word register or control word register. So who can write this command word register or set reset this control word register or mode set register? Here we can call it as a mode set register. Who can set this register? A CPU is set this register. So mode set register is used to programming the 8257. So we are not directly programming the interface. You are programming the CPU. Then CPU is send the information to the DMA. You can to the mode set register. So nothing but which channel we are going to access or otherwise. So which mode this DMA is going to add. So that will gives this mode set register. So which channel will operate first, or which channel will individually operate. So the function of the mode set register is to enable the DMA channels individually and also sets the various modes of operations. Okay, you remember all the things. So the function of this mode set register is to enable the DMA channels individually and to set the various modes of operations. This is okay. Another one is the status register. Very easy that one. What is the status register? So this is the 8-bit status register. So this 8-bit status register is divided into the 4 bits. We are only using this 4-bit lower order for this is the higher order. This is lower order. This only we are using this 4 bits one. It's lower order 4 bits. So what is their status? You know that status. So which operation it is going to perform? So simply status of the DMA control. Nothing but we are using the lower order 4 bits of the register. So it has the contains the terminal count status of the for individual channels. If any of the bits is set, it indicates that the specific channel has to reach the terminal count condition. You can see this. You just remember this one. If any of the bit is set, for suppose up to this 4 bits, set means here 1. So this is channel 0, channel 1. So this is channel 2, this is channel 3. So for this 4, out of this 8-bit register, only 4 bits are used because it is in the 8257, you have only the 4 channels. That's why 4 bits are available. If it is set, for suppose this is set, is equal to the 1, channel 0. It is 1, channel, it is bit D0, D1, D2, D3, for suppose. If it is 0, channel 0, D1 is 1, channel 1. It indicates that channel 1, it reaches to the terminal. If it is D3 is set, is equal to the 1. Nothing but channel 4 is reaches to the nothing but the terminal count. That is the status is given by this. Okay. So we have the, you know that one read and write controller. You know that the data bus buffer, read and write, and as well as the priority resolver. You know that what is the remaining bits? You know that data bus buffer. So in the CPU to the 8257 DMA, you are connecting the data bus buffer D0 to the D7 to send the information to set or reset the MSR and all mode set register. Okay, at the same time you have the read as well as the write as well as the A0 lines to set the MSR for programming that one. At the same time you have the some memory read cycles and as well as memory writes. Okay, so this read and write control logic, these are the read and write control logic is used to set or reset the command word list. The information is going to that DMA through this D0 to the D7 databases. So what is that priority resolver? You know that out of that 4 channels, channel 0, channel 1, channel 2, channel 4 channels. But suppose channel 1 as well as channel 3 is giving a request. At the same time, you are giving interrupt request or nothing but the memory accessing request at the same time. So this 2 input output device, channel 0, channel 2 input output devices is going to given the, send the information to the DMA. You want the information from the memory. Which channel is executed first? channel 0 is executed first, then after to the channel 2. You know that the channel 0, whenever you are connecting any of the input output bus to the channel 0, that is the highest priority, then coming to the channel 2 and channel 1 and channel 2. So this is solved by this priority reserve. Or whenever you are programming this one, you want to change the priorities of this channel 0, channel 1, channel 2, channel 3. Or you write the programming. So according to that one, maybe channel 1 has the highest priority when compared to the channel 0. You write the program. So nothing but program means you write the programming to the CPU. The CPU send the information to the DMA through this data lines. So you know, you see this a priority reserve. This is the this is the priority. You programming that one, then only you have to change the functionality of that channels. Then next one, we are going to see the this pin diagram. This is the 40 pin DIP dual in package. This is the 40 pin DIP. Okay, so so you know that out of this 40 pins, we have some data lines D0 to the 7 lines. So very simple. You are dividing simply. See this for any of the controller. It may be DMA. It may be 8255 or it may be interrupt controller. Whatever. You just divide into the CPU side as well as input output side. That is the way to remember easily. So this is what are the CPU side numbers D0 to the D7. Again, you know that read bar, you know that WR bar, you know that MIO bar lines, memory read, memory write lines. Okay, interrupt request lines, interrupt nothing but acknowledgement line. Hold lines, hold acknowledgement lines. These are the some of the lines. Then at the same time, you have the lines called the A0 to the A7 lines. This is the CPU side. Then what about this input output side? You know that for every channel, you have the two lines. Every channel, you have the two lines. See this diagram. Every channel, you have the two lines. DRQ at the same time, this is the request. This is the acknowledgement. Data request, this is the acknowledgement. Who can request this one? An input output device is requesting the channel 0. So whenever it may be ready to accept that one, send the information as acknowledge. So these are the how many requests are there? 4 requests and 4 acknowledgements are there. So simply you have DRQ 0 to the 3. The same time acknowledgement. What are the 4 acknowledgement signals? What are the 4 acknowledgement signals? Four acknowledgement signals. What are the 4 acknowledgement signals? DACK, whatever. DACK bar. 0, 2, 3. 4. 4 acknowledgements. Okay. You know that at the same time you have the VCC and the ground. Okay. Then at the same time, clock. Separately giving the clock. So at the same time, you have the number AEN as well as CSP. Then that's over. Maybe one is the TC. That's over. Memory read at the same time, memory read signal, memory write signal at the same time, input output read as well as input output write signals. So ready signal, then hold signal, hold acknowledgement signal. So see, this is the way we are going to remember the pin. So when you remember this architecture, is very much easier to draw the. So all the pins that are available in the pin diagram is available here. See this available here. All the pins. So when you remember the architecture, it is very much easier to draw the pin. Okay. So what is this DRQ lines? You know that DRQ. You know that DRQ lines. You have different types of lines are there. See this. DRQ lines, acknowledgement lines. That are the difference. You know that remaining R. So DRQ means here data request. So who can request the data? Who can request the data? An input output device is given request to the an input output device is given request to the DMA. So that is the DRQ. How many lines are there? 4 lines. So 4 types of input output devices you are going to connect this. using these four DRQ lines. A single bit DRQ lines. So nothing but DRQ0 has the highest priority, DRQ0 has the highest priority, and DRQ3 is the lowest priority among them. You know that because DRQ0 is connected to the channel 0 and DRQ3 is connected to the channel 3. So this is connected to the channel 0, that is. So this is acknowledgement signals. Nothing but these are the active low DMA acknowledgement. This is the DMA request lines. This is the DMA acknowledgement lines. Acknowledgement means whenever the input output request is accepted by this DMA, then it sends send the information to the this is DMA. See this DMA or see this DMA. DMA. So this see this arrows. This is DRQ. So input output device. Right. Yes. So this input output device, see this. You see this? This input output device is sending the request to the DMA. I want to access the or I want the information from the memory. If this DMA is ready to accept that request, it sends the DACK, nothing but acknowledgments. This is the arrows you see. So you know that D0 to the 7 is bidirectional data lines using it. This is the IO read signal. This is the IO. IO means here input output read signal, input output write signal. So this is the clock. So this clock is clock frequency signal is required to the internal operation of the clock. So we are using nearly 3 megahertz clock for this 8257. So a reset position, you know that A0 to the lines for address position, you know that chip selection and all, you know that remaining all. So what is the HRQ is nothing but the hold. A DMA is send the information to the series CPU. How that input output device is send the information or nothing but the see this how this you know that how that input output devices is send the DRQ lines or acknowledgement lines like input output devices. Likewise DMA is also request the CPU in the form of request lines, nothing but whole lines. As this is HRQ means here hold. This sends the HLDN means an acknowledgement. Likewise, DRQ and DAQ. You are sending the information, nothing but input output devices wants the, or it sends the request to the DMA. So DMA is given acknowledgement to that input output device. Before DMA is given acknowledgement to that input output device, DMA is interact with the CPU. I am going to read the information from the memory device. Or I am going to write the information from the write operation. I am going to perform read operation, write operation to or from the memory device. So if that CPU is accept that request, it sends the signal like hold acknowledgement to this DMA. Then only DMA send the DAQ, nothing but DMA acknowledgement to this input output device. First input output device is given request to the DMA, then DMA send the request to the CPU, that CPU accept the request at the same then only DMA is send the information to the input output device. These are the memory read memory write signals. So AAN, so you know that AAN signal is to disable address as well data bus. So this is also called as a ALE address latch enable. Address latch enable. You know that because why? Because you read and write the information from the memory. Nothing but you have the only data and address lines for that purpose. Okay. So what is the DMA transfer and its operations? What is the DMA transfer? So it can be DMA maybe operating three modes. So by writing the mode set register, So DME operation, read and write operation, as well as the read operation, three modes. So how this operation is performed? As I said, CPU. This is CPU. This is DMA. DMA. This is channels we are going to connect. Input output devices. Four input output devices. This is HRQ. This is, you can also call it as a hold acknowledgement signal. It is nothing but HLDA. Hold acknowledgement signal. You see this. First of all, any input output device is request the 8257 in the form of DRQ. So this series, I will change the pen color. So input output device is request the DMA. This DMA is accept this DMA is send the information to the CPU. What information? An input output device is requesting the it want the data from the memory. This input output device is send the DMA request to the DMA. What is the meaning of that request? This input output device is ready to read the information from the memory or write the information to the memory. So that information is sent to the directly, this DMA is sent that information to the CPU in the form of HRQ, hold signal, and in the form of request signal, RQ signal. The CPU is accept that whatever the DMA request that one, it sends the signal hold acknowledgement or grant signal. So then only DME is send the acknowledgement signal to this input. This all the information is this one. Whatever I am telling the team, this is all that. This is very simple operation. An input output device is requesting the DMA controller to access the memory. So this DMA send the information to the CPU. I am going to access the memory. So the CPU is accepting that request, then only DMA is send the information to that input output device. We are going to access in that memory. Okay. So first of all, if channel 0, channel 1, channel 2, channel 3, you have 4 channels. So out of this four channels, channel 0 as well as channel 2 is going to given the request to that DMA. DMA 8257 DMA. Two channels simultaneously giving request to the DMA. Which channel is operating? This case will call it as the burst transfer. If more than one channel requests services simultaneously, the transfer will occur as a burst transfer. So to avoid this one, we are using it as a priority resolver. Nothing but that means DRQ is simplified as the highest priority recognized during the next transfer. Is nothing but. So channel 0 as the highest priority, channel 2 is the lowest priority when compared to channel. So first one, this is first executed, then after the executed second. So this is the way you want to programming the register, a mode set register to operate this one. So priorities of the DMA. Priorities can be two types. Fixed priority scheme as well as rotating priority scheme. In fixed priority scheme, channel 0 has the highest priority. Channel 3 has the lowest priority. Wait, please wait.